Welcome back, everybody, to another Empire Motor Club. I'm in the 7 Series now. I know you guys have been asking me about this. I bought this car maybe over a year and a half ago. I've been driving it a little bit on the weekends, but mostly it's just a family car. So for this 7, as you can see, I have the M steering wheel here. I thought that this was a little bit more sportier. This was actually from the original owner. He put this in. I think he has very good taste. You know, when I bought the car from him, he still had the plastic bags and the wraps and the cellophane on everything. So he really took care of this car. It has an Alpina kit on it. It has the BC Forge Alpina light rims. And then we have some Brembo brakes on this thing. It's lowered. As you guys know, I like my cars really, really low. And everybody knows Sonny bought the M5. So I have this BMW, and the next car, you know, yeah, I don't know if you guessed it, but yeah, it is a BMW. Okay, so which model, we'll go and find out, but you can probably take a guess. I can probably guess what it is already, because I need the space, right? So this is the biggest SUV that BMW has ever made. I like it a lot because it has a lot of functions, a lot of options and amenity. So I'll take you to go check it out and see if you guys didn't guess it already. We're almost there, so stay tuned. Okay, so we're going to go to Jing Di Qi Che. I'm going to take you guys to come see the new car, all right? Have you guys guessed what it was already? What it is already? Okay, so check it out. This is it. This is the BMW X7, okay? I'm going to bring my guy Aaron over here, and then he's going to tell us more about this car. Like, Aaron, come on. So this is sales, Aaron, 金地汽车，我觉得他们超级专业的 ，OK？ 我在这之中我看过很多车，那我后来还是决定了 X7。那你跟我们来，我跟你讲为什么我决定 X7。Come on， Aaron， 来介绍一下吧。这个是这一台
X7呢，台湾总代理就已经一个版本，那它把很多额外要选配的配备全部都放到上面。那我们以外观来看，在外观的部分，它都新款的 LED 大灯。 然后配上它的侧边踏板，
明白？22寸的铝圈，这些东西都全部列为标配。哦，所以这个都是标配。对对。很多网友不是很喜欢这一点，但我个人觉得新款的这个大的这个 grille 是蛮帅的，很霸气，但不是所有人都喜欢。对对。OK， 来，我们来看一下吧。为什么我买这台车最大的原因就是因为它室内的空间。OK， 因为你们知道我有很多小孩。来 ，Aaron， 你来介绍一下吧。
因为它这叫做 X740i 豪华版，
这台是 V6 Twin Turbo，
对， 3.0，
大概多少匹马力？这个的话，它做到
340匹。
OK，
对，我那天有开过啊，我觉得吹起来蛮有力的，对，就很轻盈啊，是，就是不会像有那种哦，真的开七人座很笨重的。
OK，
我觉得它最不错的地方是，像它增很多地方都增比包覆，是。那以 BMW 的车来说呢，它如果内装有菱格纹。 的话，就代表它这台车是最高级的。
哦，这是 merino leather，
对，这就是所谓的
merino leather。
对，没错。
OK，
那后座的部分呢，它的前后跟椅背全部都是可以用电动的方式来去做调。OK，所以你那个有给我看，哎
，check this out，这个就是这样，你按一次，然后它自己就会动。所以我觉得这个蛮酷的，而按一次就，
对，它就回到原位了。
哦，这个很棒，这个很棒。好，我们来看一下这是最后面，所以这个是重点，因为你们知道我长跑以来，所以我必须要这东西是有很大，它有一个我可以直接这样，然后它就全收吗？
对，这个先这样。
我刚刚前面摇收，看哇，这个
，That's pretty fucking cool, man. Transformers, okay.
OK，所以你可以看这个后面大概也可以睡个两个人了，
没有问题，应该是没有问题，对不对
？OK， 那还有什么特别要介绍的嘞？我们可以讲内装。内装来 ，OK， 所以我那天大概有开过了，那我觉得它很酷的是它也有很多 setting， 当然，然后我觉得它的整个这个新的这个界面，它充满了各式各样不同的这个 options 跟这个设定了。那我觉得这次最酷的事情。 其实是一个很小的事情 ，OK， 是这个，我喜欢这个，它的这个冷热的功能在杯子的这个地方，所以我如果热饮的话，我可以开热的功能；我如果冷的饮料，我可以开冷的功能。但是真的有用吗？
有一点点用。
有一点点油 ，OK， 蛮老实的。
你手这样放下去，其实会感觉到那么一点点冷风。
哦，对对。
但这个是这个，我觉得是整台车最浮夸的东西了。这个是什么东西？
它这个的话，原厂是说了是施华洛世奇设计的水晶排档。
我说它真的是 Swarovski 就是了 ，OK。
对 对, 对。然后内装的部分的话，还有一个很大的特点是它的全景式天窗。对，那一般其实全景天它只有两片，它是做三片式。
而且我之前那个 GL 的第三片，它没有 visor， 它没有那个，
对，它就是一个透明，
就一个玻璃，
对 对, 对。所以变成说你要去贴隔热纸，它才有隔热。
OK， 因为那个孩子坐有时候常会说哦太热了。
对啊对啊。
那这个是后面可以关起来。
对，没错。
我们来看一下这个。所以我觉得这个是真的还蛮酷，因为它遮起来之后是就是完全看不到太阳。
对，因为像它这个的话，
蛮厚的。
对，很厚。
对，因为我的机钥匙你关起来它还是亮的，对，还是亮的。我觉得谢谢 Aaron， 我觉得你们超专业的，我很高兴买到这台车，那我等不及开去宜兰。So, I've had this car for a couple weeks already. I gotta tell you, man, I've driven the shit out of this thing. Maybe in the last 3 weeks, I've put about 4,500 km on it. We took it all the way down south to Kunding, and it was amazing, man. We took it to Yilan almost every day last week, too. And then when you get into Shui Sui, you hit that assist, and it's fucking awesome. Like, I don't even know how I used to drive that thing, like manually, you know? You can kind of just chill and relax. It still alerts you when you're kind of like,dozing off a little bit or not paying attention. So you have to hold on to the wheel. It has these alert lights on the steering column and the steering wheel that'll alert you when it's like yellow or red. That's when you know you gotta like touch the steering wheel, right? So I think the functions are really cool. It's a really intelligent car. Really hard to get into an accident. The other day I was pulling out of my driveway and then, you know, a scooter came out of nowhere. And this is Taipei, so scooters are everywhere. And it just like stopped. I thought I hit something, you know, but it wasn't. It detected scooter driver and it automatically stopped for me, which is kind of crazy if you think about it, you know? But yeah, this car is really intelligent. So far, there are things that I love about this car. A few things that I don't like about this car is that it's almost a little too smart. There's a couple functions that you have to turn off. The lane lock, where it like, keeps you into one lane, and then if you drift off, it'll pull you back. That stuff is crazy, man. I hate that. I had to turn that off like the first time I hit the freeway. But anyways, besides that, I love it.The next thing is we're gonna EMC it out. So you know what I'm talking about. Tell me what you guys wanna see us do to this car. Hopefully we'll get all the parts in and we'll do another one of these to show you guys the final version of this X7. Stay tuned, check it out, all right? Comment, subscribe, and let us know. Thanks, guys.